right, well, the Blackhawks and the Columbus Blue Jackets have already played twice in the preseason. They'll meet in a real game tonight. Columbus record in doing that, a plus 33. Here's Hartman throwing it across. Kane to the net. He shoots, he scores! Patrick Kane in his first shift of the night steps over the boards and fired it by the glove of Corpusello. And the Hawks have the lead, but they've also got a man down. Nick Schmaltz still has not moved. He went awkwardly to the end boards, and you can see he's in trouble.
Remember, Nick Schmaltz left partway through that third period a couple of nights ago against the Pittsburgh Penguins, and yeah, he's in a little bit of pain. But what a play by Patrick Kane. He realizes he's got time and space, and he just looks for a spot. And boy, there's nobody better than hitting his spot than that man, number 88. I love the follow through. Watch the release. Head up, sees his spot, and then that quick snapshot cleanly beats the glove of Corpusello. There's that hit. That was Jack Johnson, who's 230 pounds on Schmaltz.
Right off the boards. He did against two players. Here's a tough attempt. Oh, and a mishandle at the last moment by Anisimov. Then Keith. Sharp's long blast. Corpusello had a good look. Side in the neighborhood. I do not think he was in the shooting lane that time.
Went right from his belly into his glove.
Here's a tip. Oh, Sharp was looking for a stick the whole way. He got it. The rebound came back to Saad, who got the original tip. That's four goals in 3.5 periods of play this year for Brandon Saad.
Boy, and he was happy to score that one. Watch the celebration after the play, but good work by the Blackhawks, winning the draw, getting it back to the point, and then getting bodies to the point. And after that shot, watch number 20 sitting right in the middle of the ice. He actually tipped that shot by Patrick Sharp. He picks up the rebound. Jack Johnson trying to clear number 20, but it's too late. Brandon Saad willing to pay the price to score the goal. He does. The Blackhawks lead it 2-0.
Well, good news for the Hawks. He's back into the battle as Crawford makes two saves, the second on Milano. Root out of the corner, panic. Now Jones. Here to Cam Atkinson, whose feed was broken up. Hayden. On Hayden steams back in, trying to get up the middle. He did with a shot. Corpusello, a fine point-blank save after a great Hayden rush.
It was 1-on-4, Pat. I didn't think he had any room to do anything, and he showed a great burst of speed, splitting the D and getting a shot.
It's cleared back ahead. Kane's got it. Sharp heading for the net. Kane around to check. He dances. He shoots. And a save by Corpusello. Rebound taken by the visitors. Now Panarin broke up Keith. Pass along. Shot by Savard. Handled by Crawford. Rebound back to Savard, a long wrist shot. Good save, Crawford. It nearly came loose, but he's able to reach out and capture with a couple of jackets in the neighborhood. Wrist shot hit the backside of DeBrincat. Might have an odd man rush the other way. Kane's the trigger man. DeBrincat heading for the net. Here's Kane waiting around a check. He'll shoot it. Save, Corpusello. Patrick Kane calmly dangling right to the middle of the ice. But Corpusello beat him that time.
Good.
Dropped it across. Here's a wraparound by Panic. He thought he scored. It hit Corpusello, went up into the air between his arm and his body, but apparently never crossed the line. Jones hit hard by Panic, who took the puck away. Now Taze, he scores! A Richard Panic forecheck. I should say a Jonathan Taze for a Panic forecheck and a Taze goal. It's 3-0.
Boy, a couple of big hits here in the last 30 seconds, and it's changed the momentum. Columbus Blue Jackets were coming on with some strong shifts, but first a hit by Wingles, and then a huge crunch by Richard Panic. And that's a big man back there, 6'4" Seth Jones takes him off the puck. Quick pass there by Saad to Taves. That's in his wheelhouse, and that's an important goal for Jonathan Taves. Just one goal in his first 10 games last year. He scores here early.
Nick Foligno here. On a center one, it hit a Hawks player, went in. The centering pass hit, I believe, Kipney went down to block the feed and dribbled into the net. So the Jackets on a fortunate bounce around the board.
Well, it's funny, Pat, because Michael Kipney had fallen on the play. I thought maybe he got tripped up, but he had fallen a little earlier. He tried to scramble back up. Watch number 6 go down. He reaches backwards, and as he heads to the net, that looks like it went off of Ryan Hartman, who tried to come in and help out. It goes right off his pads. Watch 38 slide in. And it just goes off of his right knee. Corey actually stopped it. Milano, I think, is going to be credited with this goal. Milano scored his first NHL goal last night.
Kane with Wingles heading for the net. Kane does too, but had to spin back. Threw it in front. Here's Rudy scores! What a pass by Patrick Kane! That went through three bodies to find a wide open Jan Ruda. He's got his first NHL goal in his second game, and it's 4-1.
And that's all Patrick Kane again on the backhand. Nobody better at passing the puck on his backhand than number 88. Watch the puck possession, cuts back with it, and he's looking about 55 feet across the ice to Jan Ruda, puts it right on his stick. He saucered that about 55 feet, and Ruda makes sure.
And a good play to Sedlak. He failed to clear. Tate, Keith, a one-timer. And a save, Ruda. Oh, what a save, Corposano, Saad. Can't believe he didn't finish that one. Here's Keith.
That shot came from the point. Big rebound. The Duncan Keith blast, the blocker save, and that's right out of midair, maybe 3 feet off the ice. And yeah, it did trickle through the legs of Corposalo. His defenseman helped bail him out, stopped him before it crossed the goal line. Blackhawks have scored again.
The faceoff win gives a rip to Panic, and Richard Panic, who really did not get an assist on that play Steve just showed you, where he forecheck beautifully took a man off the puck. He didn't get a point there. He's got one here off a Tate faceoff.
Yeah, watch him jump on this loose puck. He kind of lifts the stick of Werenski, falls down, and what a release. Coaching staff will tell you one of the best releases on this team. You see him just lift up the stick of Werenski. Werenski goes down. He picks up the puck and absolutely wastes no time shelfing it. Fifth Blackhawks goal.
Well, the Columbus Blue Jackets had a one-sided win last night. Different story this evening. The Blackhawks, for the second straight game to open the year, have come up with a one-sided victory. In two games, the Hawks have scored 15 goals. The team they're going to play on Monday, the Toronto Maple Leafs, in two games have scored 15 goals. We might have a shootout in the Air Canada Centre Monday night. And the Blackhawks happy with the first 4 points they've achieved.